Today, we are diving into the fascinating world of soil moisture sensors. I will show you how they work, the different types, and how to assemble them with Arduino. Plus, we'll build two amazing projects together. But before we get our hands dirty, let's start with a simple question. What is a soil moisture sensor and how does it work? A soil moisture sensor is a tiny device that measures the water level in soil. They can work alone or in automated systems for real-time monitoring, making them crucial for several applications in agriculture, gardening, environmental monitoring, and more. There are different types of sensors, but we can divide them into two groups, resistance-based and capacitance-based. The resistance-based devices have two electrodes. When inserted into the soil, these sensors measure the electrical resistance between the electrodes. As the soil moisture increases, its conductivity also increases, so the resistance between the electrodes goes down. Then, this change in resistance is converted into a moisture reading. On the other hand, the capacitance-based sensors measure the dielectric permittivity of the soil. The presence of water in the soil changes its dielectric permittivity, which in turn affects the capacitance of the sensor. Later, this change is measured to determine the soil moisture. Now that you understood the principles behind these sensors, it's time to see them working on real projects. First, we'll build a simple soil moisture monitor with Arduino according to these schematics. Here's what you need: Arduino board, breadboard, jumper wires, resistance-based soil moisture sensor, 3 LEDs, red, yellow, green, 3 220 ohms resistors, and a glass of water. Connect the 5V and GND ports of the Arduino to the breadboard. Attach the sensor power supply pins to 5V and GND rows and the signal pin to A5. Set up the LEDs with resistors on the breadboard. Connect them to GND and ports 2, 3, and 4. Then, access the GitHub repository of this project. I've put the link on the description below. Download the soil moisture monitor file and upload it to Arduino. Let's see our project working. After diving the sensor legs completely into the glass of water, we have an extremely wet situation. Diving only a small part of the sensor gives us the wet scenario, and the system responds accordingly. Now, if we remove the sensor from the water, the reading value is so low that the red LED is turned off, indicating an extremely dry scenario. While resistance-based sensors are cheaper, they suffer from corrosion and therefore have a short lifespan. That's why you should not use them in real-life applications. On the other hand, the capacitance-based sensors are usually more expensive, but they are more durable because of the way they work. Now that you understood the main differences between this type of sensors, let's get our hands dirty again. We are going to create an irrigation system using a capacitance-based sensor, as you can see in these schematics. For this project, you'll need Arduino board, battery support, batteries, breadboard, capacitance-based soil moisture sensor, 5V relay module, small pump, glass of water, plant, and wires. Connect the relay module to the Arduino and pour it with batteries. Attach the water pump to the relay. Connect the soil moisture sensor to the Arduino and place the sensor in the soil and the pump in the water. Upload the irrigation system file and watch your automated irrigation system in action. As you may notice, every time we send a signal from Arduino port 2, the relay will close the water pump circuit and then water will flow to irrigate the plant. When we stop the signal, the water pump will turn off. The sensor readings will inform Arduino when is the right time to start or stop the signal from port 2. If you power the Arduino board continuously and add water to the reservoir from time to time, your irrigation system will work non-stop. That's the principle at building fully automated irrigation systems. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more do-it-yourself projects. If you don't want to wait for the next video, check out this tutorial where I teach you how to build an alarm system with Arduino.